Without further ado, enjoy Seussical Jr.
Now that is a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be a creature they call the gazette, who balances things on his head because it's flat. Or a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bat. Or a sort of a kind of a hat-wearing cat. I can see that you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, one think, and you drag me right onto the stage. Now that I'm here, there's no telling what may ensue. With a cat such as me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think, oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a geek with a stink, or a stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose. Oh, the things you can think, when you think about Seuss.
Oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose. Oh,
shade of the day. In the cool of the moon, splashing, enjoying the jungle's great joys. And when Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant heard a small noise.
Help! Help!
So Horton stopped splashing. He looked toward the sound.
That's funny,
thought Horton.
There's no one around. That is able to yell. So you know what I think? I think there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear. Then a blow in the pool. He's no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save him, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
So gently and using the greatest of care, the elephant stretched his stretch on through the air. Then he lifted the dust sack and carried it over and placed it down.
Safe.
Talk about
Thank you.
began. We must both lay down the law.
Will he hate us?
Maybe so. Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has all the answers? I don't know. I have just been elected, and upright behavior is thenceforth expected.
We've just had a talk with your teachers today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You invented new things, which defy all description.
You gave Mrs. O'Dooley a nervous conniption.
Your things were so wild, they disrupted your classes. You made Mrs. McElhoo drop her new glasses, which is why you're suspended.
Yes, that's what they said.
Young man, what and who has gotten into your head? Now, Horton has found us. We're safe on a clover. But clearly our troubles are far, far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you. Oh, yes, dear. But couldn't you try just thinking a little bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take your bath and go to bed.
And think some normal things instead. You got me in trouble! Get out! Go away!
All right, I'll be going. But first, let me say... Oh, the things you can think.
Just stop.
The things you can think.
Be quiet.
Apple splash, me splish.
I'm not listening.
La, 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 la. Have a think in the tub. Think of water and fish.
Fish?
Think of pipes in the floor, leaning down to the shore, where the water is cool. Soon your tub's not a tub.
It's McGilligan's pool.
This might be a pool like a grown up in books, connected to one of those underground brooks. An underground river that starts here and flows right under this bathtub. And then, who knows, it's possible. Anything's possible. It might go along down where no one can see, right under State Highway 203, right under the wagons, right under the toes of Mrs. Ocorso, who's hanging up clothes. It's possible. Anything's possible. It's possible. Anything's possible. This might be a river now, mightn't it be? Connecting my Gallagher's pool with the sea. Then maybe some fish might be swimming, swimming toward me.
Overflowed on the floor. The water is running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling. You flooded the den. Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again.
See, this is worthless and terrible sorrow. Young man, we will deal with you come tomorrow.
I still think that I'm
Good night, Horton. See you in Seussical. Who enters?
The bird.
Love song cohort number 437. She had the smallest plain tail ever was. One droopy droop feather was all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled it, she dyed it, she gave it a puff. She decked it with flowers, but it wasn't enough. For no matter what, it just was what it was. A tail that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. The one feather tail of Miss Gertrude McFess.
This is wonderful, second, third. Wow, I'm colorful. Turn over. least you're kind and you're powerful. Heart, so notice me more time.
Oh, be something.
And notice me more time.
Then notice the thing or two.
Notice me more time.
It's hopeless.
You said it, kid.
Who's there?
It's me. Maisie? Up here?
Maisie, are you on a... Are you on a tree?
Yeah? You want to make something of it?
No, no. I just never thought I'd see you on a tree.
Neither did I, Cor. Neither did I.
Why, Maisie, I couldn't, of all silly things. I haven't got feathers, I haven't got wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a search. I just couldn't leave my poor hoods in the lurch.
I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back, because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I promise, I'll fly back real soon. I'd only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, we all need vacations. All right, go on, take it. I'll sit on your egg, and I'll try not to break it. But please come back quickly. 1 hour, maybe two. I need to find JoJo. I've got to say who.
Thank you.
what I said. This egg might get frozen, but the ooze might be dead. I couldn't say no when I heard Maisie beg, but I can't desert this egg, and I will not abandon her. Help! Somebody help! Hunters!
Now, let's see.
What, Maisie? It's me, Horton. Remember? It's me. I've sat on your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through lightning and hailstones and snow. Won't you take back your egg?
Gee, I really don't know. Oh, wow, it's really late. And gee, I've got a date. And lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you. Who would ever guess? Look at you. Such a big success. And it's all thanks to me. Amazing Horton, the exiting circus sensation. Major Horton, up on Maisie's nest. Amazing Horton, while I was off taking vacation. You made your fortune up on Maisie's nest. I may be unreliable, fancy free, irresponsible, crazy. Just for once, I built something right. The egg is all yours. No one will thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck. And goodbye.
I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%. And now, little eggs, you're alone in the universe too. Who would have thought you'd be left up to me? A fool of an elephant up in a tree. Well, this time I swear, I'll do better than try. I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young A, and I'll sing you a lullaby. Faraway land, so the stories all tell, somewhere beyond the horizon. If we can find it, then all will be well. Troubles there are few. Someday we'll go to Seussical. Chocho too. I hope they'll make it to Seussical. High on a mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find it. I have a picture of how it will be on the day I do. Troubles will be through. I'll be home. Oh,
about Gertrude Fuzz. Well, that's nothing new. Everyone does. But Gertrude did something that few birds could do. This is a tale of Miss Gertrude, part two. Psst. Horton. Horton, you there?
Who's there?
Horton. Oh, Horton, I've been worried sick. Are you okay?
Gertrude, how did you find us?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little, it was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying. To the doctor.
The doctor named Dick, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And she said,
Dr. Dick, I've been foolish and vain. Pluck it out. Get it off. I won't do it again.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Oof, a tender spot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just a one feather tail. But suddenly, for you.
This is the case of people versus horses.
only I can see.
There's a big bull in the jungle, I know.
It's true, sir. Here's who, sir. He's a who and so is she.
He's a big bull in the jungle, I know. Time to respect, time to respect, to respect the
objection!
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%. You can throw me in jail, lock me up in a zoo, but I won't desert my egg, and I will not abandon the room. These who's, sir, win or lose, sir, whether you believe or not. These who's, sir, they live in fear, and I'm the only friend they've got. You can do what you want with me, Your Honor, and I won't question why. But please save who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the vengeance in the evidence.
Mr. Mayor, oh please, Mr. Mayor, you have to prove now that you really are there. So ring every doorbell, send out the word, make every who holler, make every who heard.
Attention all who's! Attention all who's! We've got to be heard!
There's no time to lose.
So send up a shout.
Make it loud and clear.
We are here! We are here! We are here!
No matter how small, and you very small persons will not have to die to make yourselves heard. So please try.
Boil it, boil it, boil it, boil it.
We are here, we are here, we are here, we are here.
Boil it, boil it, boil it, boil it.
Think of something.
And just for a moment, Doug Jojo looked grim. The fate of the Who's rested squarely on him. And then came a new thing, a peculiar new word. Kind of a word no one ever had heard.
Did you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They made themselves heard, though they still can't be seen.
They proved they are persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
Sour kangaroo. But from now on, you know what I'm planning to do? From now on, I'm planning to protect them with you.
Much more than that.
I have wings. I can fly. You teach him earth, and I will teach him sky.
Just call my name, and I'll see you through. One small voice in the universe,
one true friend in the universe.
The adventure is over. The sky became pink. And now guess what happens?
Well,
what do you think?
Six.